Ontario promised to be accessible by 2025, and this was all the way back in 2005. The plan was to break down barriers for people living with disabilities from getting their health card, for instance, to going shopping. But with 2 years to go before the deadline, how close or how far are we from that goal? Well, one disability advocate says he's been having to resort to filing a Freedom of Information application to force Ontario Premier Doug Ford to make public a final report of the government's progress. Now, for more on this, I'm joined by that activist. This is David Lepofsky. He's the chair of Accessibility for Ontarians with Disabilities Act Alliance. And David, thank you for starters for joining us. I guess the first thing I'd like to ask you off the top, sir, Donovan's report here, the one that we've been talking about or mentioning, this interim report was originally released within 8 days, but why the holdup, you think, for this final one?
The government is defying provincial legislation by keeping secret a report that the Accessibility for Ontarians with Disabilities Act requires be made public. Now, each government that's gotten one of these reports that are required every few years has taken, you know, a couple of months or whatever to look them over. None have dragged it out this long. And what's significant is this: we are far behind the goal of getting becoming an accessible province, the goal that the province is required to lead us to under the accessibility law that we fought for a decade from 1994 to 2005. The province has no comprehensive plan to get us there by 2025 or ever. The Donovan report was required to give the government recommendations on what that action plan should be. The Ford government's had it since June 6th. Why are they keeping it secret when the public has a right to see it and to see it now?
So what are you thinking, David? Is it more of a question of what's in the report that's maybe scathing or indicating how far the gap is between now and where we're supposed to be in 2025? Or do you think it's something else? What do you think is not being seen in the light of day right now?
I'm the wrong person to ask because the premier hasn't talked to us since the day he took office. He's the first premier in two decades that's refused to talk to the nonpartisan coalition that I have the privilege of leading as a volunteer. And for the past 2 years, his accessibility minister his accessibility minister's office has refused to talk to us. So unfortunately, we don't know because they're not talking to us at the political level.
David, can you give us a bit more for some of our viewers, particularly a history lesson here? To go, we don't necessarily have to go all the way back to 94 and go through everything. I think I wish we could. But what are some of the things that people need to bear in mind? We're talking about now almost three decades there.
We should, for example, look at the fact that the late Lieutenant Governor David Onley said that the national unemployment rate facing people with disabilities in Canada is not only a national crisis, but a national shame. Well, you can't get a good job if you can't get a good education. But our education system is full of barriers that make it much harder for students with disabilities to succeed. The government's had on its desk for almost 2 years an action plan on how to fix that. Results: no new regulations, which we were promised, and no specific commitments of new action. So that's just one illustration of the kind of barriers that 2.9 million people with disabilities face. And disability eventually affects everybody. You just get older, you get a disability. So when the government fails to address these needs, it's ultimately hurting everyone.
It's hurting everyone, you say, David, but what about, how are you feeling right now as one example there? For the last question, seeing another report that's not being implemented, it seems, or even being addressed or made public. How are you feeling right now?
Frustrated, but more determined than ever. We've got the law on our side. We've got a Freedom of Information file. The government's going to have to make this thing public. They might as well get it over with and make it public tomorrow.
David Lepofsky joining us now from Toronto. I thank you very much for your time. Lepofsky is the chair of Accessibility for Ontarians with Disabilities Act Alliance. And again, sir, thank you again.
Thanks so much.